Today we will see how to integrate the bottom navigation bar in our application. But this is how it looks like in its final form. The bottom navigation bar allows us to switch between different contexts in our app. So in our case, it's about emails, the first item, contacts, and maybe eventually calendar. Let's see how it's done. Okay, so this is where we left last time. So I will start by changing the color because I don't like this color anymore. And now let's extract this list of messages along with the tabs to a separate widget. And I will introduce this small convention which says that everything, like the full screen, I mean the widget that is meant to display the whole screen, will have a screen suffix added at the end. So let me just show you how what I mean. So I will create an inbox screen widget. And let's start with the stateless widget. Let's import that. So this will be a scaffold and a body. Child text inbox. Like that. So now here in app, we will remove, first of all, we will remove the default tab controller. We will take this part, the app bar, and we will place it in our new widget, inbox. Like so. Now here we can remove that part. We can remove the drawer. We will take the body and we will put it here in the inbox screen. So this part can be removed. This needs to be imported. Like so. So here in app, let's just display something so the error disappears. Okay, so now in the app widget, so the first thing we need to do is to convert app to a stateful widget. I will do it like that. And here, let's remove that part and let's copy this. Okay. Now, let's add the bottom navigation part. So there is a parameter called bottom navigation part, and there is a widget of the same name, which requires items, and each of those items is a bottom navigation bar item, which has a title. So this will be a mail. Let's add another one. Contacts, people. And let's add the third one. calendar. This will be okay. Looks good. Let's just make it a little bit better in terms of how the code looks like. Okay. Now here in body, it's just a blank screen with something at the top. We will use a list and we will say that the first parameter is inbox screen. So this widget we created. And we will use a method called element add, and we will say selected index. So this parameter is the index of currently selected item bar. So this is the state the app widget has. So this is just an integer with a default value of 0. Okay, so now we have an error because here we need to add the default tab controller we removed from the app widget, because this is the actual place for this tab. Okay, so it looks good. Now if I click, nothing happens because we haven't defined those views yet. So let's fix that. So we need to create those two other views. So the first one will be contacts screen again. So as I said, the whole assemblage, or the whole group of widgets that's displayed, I will call those widgets screens. So we can use a stateless widget here, contacts screen. Let's import. Let's do center. Contacts, that's the first one. And the other one is calendar screen. Not this one. Let's do this. Like so. Okay. So we have those two empty screens and we can add them here. So it's contacts screen and calendar screen, like that. Let's import those. I think I made a typo. Screen. Okay. Okay, so we have those. So we have three bar items defined here and three screens, three widgets that represent each section of this application. So the idea is similar to the two tabs we've seen yesterday. So the first item corresponds to the first element of this list. The second item, bar item, corresponds to the second element of the list, and so forth. So now we need to hook them up together. So we are using selected index here, but for now it's just a static value. So there is a parameter here in the bottom navigation bar, which is called onTap, and we can define a handler. on bar item top, let's say. And let's define this. Can I do it like that? So this method will use setState and we will assign the value. So now it should work, and it works indeed. The next step would be to make those screens a little bit prettier. So let's wrap, let's add scaffold, and here's body. So now contacts, and let's add the app bar with title. Perfect. Let's add drawer. This is the drawer we defined, we extracted previously, and to a widget. So now it should work as before. Same idea goes for the calendar screen. So we will just wrap this into a scaffold. This is body. We need app bar, which needs title. So it's calendar. Let's make it like so. Drawer, app drawer. Let's import it. Let's see if it works. Contacts, calendar, inbox. Okay. So now, as you can see, when I click the contacts or calendar, still the inbox is highlighted. That's because we need to define which element is current, and there is a parameter, current index, and we just need to assign the value of the selected index. So now, whenever I switch, the proper bar item is highlighted. So that looks good. We need to just fix the up bar here. So the title, we need to add the drawer as well. And there you have it, the bottom navigation bar with three screens. And the first screen we have messages, which can be filtered using the tabs. So in the next episode, we will dive into the data management. So I will stop developing the UI for a while and we will see how to handle data, because up to this point, we've been trying to come up with some solutions, but we also encountered some problems. And the idea was to give you some intuition about what can be done. But now we will see how to solve those problems and how to do the data management in a more appropriate way. That's pretty much it. And see you in the next episode.